Hi guys, we were in the topic calculation of longitude and time. So in the last video we saw how to find out time of a place if you know the longitude of that place, and today we will see how we can find out the longitude of place if you know the time of that place. So we will solve this with the help of a question, and there is a question here. So the question is, what is the longitude of station A whose local time is 9 p.m. while GMT is 3:30 p.m. So read the question one more time, you will get a clarity. So the question is saying that there are two places. One is GMT, where the longitude is 0 degree, and the time of GMT, or the Greenwich mean time, is 3:30 p.m. So if it is 3:30 p.m. there, what is the longitude of station A whose time is 9 p.m. So first thing is read and understand the question, and then we will begin like this. So first, in order to find out the longitude, first we have to list the details that we have in the question. So in the question we have two stations. One is station A, whose longitude is not known, and we have station another station that is 0 degree longitude. It is given there, Greenwich mean time. Greenwich mean time means there is a longitude or the prime meridian. Now the time of both places are given. Station A is 9 p.m. and GMT is 3:30 p.m. So what I usually do is I convert this 12-hour clock into 24-hour clock for the convenience of calculation. So 9 p.m. is 21 hours, 3:30 p.m. is 15 hours 30 minutes. That will make the calculation easy. Now moving on, the second important thing that I always do is this one: arranging the stations in the correct geographical order. What does it I mean by this? That means if you see the time of station A is 21 hours and the other station, that is GMT, is 15 hours 30 minutes. That means station A is located to the east of 0 degree longitude, because we know that the earth is rotating from west to east. Therefore the time of the place located in the east will always be ahead of the time of the place located in the west. So because of that, first thing what you can do is you arrange or you place both stations in such a manner that it is actually in the correct order. So here you can see now it's in the correct order. The place on the east is ahead of the place in the west. Okay, now in the previous type of question, what we did was when we have two different longitude, we used to find out the difference in the longitudinal or the longitudinal difference. So here we have the same thing, but instead of longitude we have two times. So the first step is to find out the difference of time. So the difference of time here is 21 hours minus 15.5, that is 15 hours 30 minutes. So the difference in time between the given two stations are 5.5 or 5 hours 30 minutes. So that is the first thing to be calculated. Now next thing, you have to keep this one formula in mind, that the rate of rotation, or the rate of rotation of the earth, is 15 hours in 1 minute, which is equal to 15 degrees. So 15 degrees in 60 minutes, or we can simplify it as 1 degree in 4 minutes, or otherwise we can say earth rotates 1 degree in 4 minutes. So now we got two things, that the difference in time between two places are, or the given two places are, 5 hours and 30 minutes, and the rate of rotation is 1 degree in 4 minutes. So if these are the scenario, what's the next step? Next step is finding out the longitude. How can we find it out? So this is what we have to do. Now next thing, we have to find out the longitudinal difference between both the places. We know the longitude of only one place, that is 0 degree longitude. So but we know the difference in time. So the next step is to find out the longitudinal difference. For this we have a formula. This is the simplest formula. So the difference in time between two stations divided by the rate of rotation. We got both the things. Difference in time we calculated, and we got it as 5 hours 30 minutes, and the rate of rotation is 1 degree in 4 minutes. So if that is the case, the longitude difference is 5 hours 30 minutes divided by 4 minutes. To make it little more easier, you can convert the 5 hours 30 minutes into minutes. That means 5 hours means 5 into 60 minutes, 300, plus 30 minutes, that is 330 minutes divided by 4. So by doing this, you will get the answer as 82.5. That means 82.5 degree is the longitudinal difference between station A and the other station given, right? So 82.5 degree is the difference. It is not the longitude. It's the difference in values of longitude between the given stations. Now the next step is you have to add this value or the longitudinal difference to the longitude of the given station, right? In order to find out the longitudinal value of the target station, our target station is station A. So in order to find out the longitude of that place, what we had to do was we had to add the longitudinal difference that we got to the longitude of the station given in the question. So in our question, the longitude of the station given is 0 degree and the longitudinal difference we got is 82.5. So it will be like this: 0 degree plus 82.5, right? Okay, now before that, it's not always addition, sometimes it will be subtraction. So how can we decide whether to add the longitudinal difference or to subtract the longitudinal difference? It's very simple. If our target station is located in the east, if our target station is located in the east, we have to add, right? You can use this shortcut method ahead. So if the time of the target station is ahead, add the longitudinal difference, right? The other thing is opposite, right? One more time. If the time of the target station is ahead, that means if the time of that station is ahead than that of the time of the given station. So in our case, the time of the target station is 9 p.m. and the time of the given station is 3:30 p.m. So in our case, the time of the given station is, target station is ahead. So we can, or we have to add the longitudinal difference that we got. Okay. So adding 82.5 degree to 0 degree longitude, we will get an answer as 82.5 degree east. Why it is east? Because whenever we add, we will have to move towards east side. From the given longitude, we have to move eastwards. In our case, we have 0 degree as the given longitude. Now the next method is by adding, by the term adding, addition means we have to move 82.5 degree eastward. If it is subtraction, not in this question, in case if you are getting another question where you have to subtract, so what you have to do is from that given longitude, you have to move westward, whatever the values. If it is 10, imagine instead of 0 degree, if it was 10 degree longitude, then what we have to do is from 10 degree longitude, we have to go 82.5 degree eastward. Right. Then the answer would be 92.5 degree east. But in our case, the given longitude is 0 degree. So we are then adding this 82.5 degree to 0 degree. So the answer is 82.5 degree east. So the station longitude of the station A is 82.5 degree east. Otherwise, we can call it as 82 degree 30 minute east. Both are same. So this is how we can find out longitude of a station if we get the time of that station. Moving on, we have the next topic, international dateline. The 180 degree longitude is called as international longitude. All of you know that it is located directly opposite to 0 degree longitude. 0 degree longitude is called as prime meridian. 180 degree longitude is called as international dateline. We don't give any value to 0 degree, it's just 0 degree, neither east nor west. Similarly, 180 degree longitude can also be taken in the same manner, right, without giving any directional values, but it can be recognized as both 180 degree west as well as 180 degree east. The thing is that if you are going to 180 degree through the east side, right, you will be going like this: 1 degree east, 2 degree east, 150 degree east, 170 degree east, then that can be called as 180 degree east. On the other hand, if you are going westward and reaching 180 degree, you can call it as 180 degree west. Both are correct. Now this is the line which is concerned with the calendar dates and days, right? And it passes through the Pacific Ocean. On the globe or on the map, it passes through the Pacific Ocean. And the interesting thing is there is a difference of 24 hours on both sides of this line that we will see in detail in the coming slides. Now here in this diagram, you can see this is the prime meridian. Directly opposite to this, we have international dateline, which is passing through the Pacific Ocean. Right. Now, I told already, we can call it as 180 degree east or 180 degree west based on the way you are going there. Now, this is how it looks like in a map. So here, 0 degree meridian or the prime meridian is passing through in London, then passing through the parts of France, then Africa, then into the Atlantic Ocean. Right, directly opposite to this, if we show it in a map, it looks like this. So the 180 degree meridian or the international dateline is passing through the Pacific Ocean. Right. Moving on. So I told you that there is a difference of 24 hours time on both side of international dateline. So suppose if this is the international dateline, we have west side here and east side here. Right? It's not a mistake. Usually we have west in the left side of the map and east in the right side of the map. But that is when we are looking to the map from the other side. Now we are looking at the map from this side. Right. Usually we look at the map from this side where we can see our country India or continents like Africa and all. Right. So this 0 degree meridian divides the earth into two hemispheres, western hemisphere and eastern hemisphere. And now we are looking at this particular diagram from the other side. That is why we have our western hemisphere on the right, or the west on the right and east in the left. Right. See, this only. Okay. Now, study this with an example. So if you see, this is the international dateline passing. It's not in a straight line, that we will discuss in detail. So you take the example of these two places. So I told you to watch this video from 9 a.m. So if you are watching this at 9 a.m. today, that is Saturday 2020, what is the date? It's 17. So if you are watching it on Saturday 9 a.m. from India, this is the live scenario. At 180 degree meridian, it will be exactly 4 p.m. right? But the interesting thing is that here in this area, this orange colored area, there it will be Saturday 4 p.m. and on the other hand, here this green color on the other side of the international date line, that is in the western hemisphere, here also it will be 4 p.m. but it will be Friday 4 p.m. here it will be Saturday 4 p.m. here it will be Friday 4 p.m. just a line on the other side, but there is a huge difference of time, 24 hours, one day time difference. Let's see how this works. It will be useful if you could do with the help of this one particular map. Now here, no need to look into all these things. You have to concentrate on these two, this line which I drawn on the top. Now here, this orange color indicates Saturday. That means all these places are now having Saturday, and the green color indicates Friday. Right, now you are here in this time zone. You are watching this video from this time zone, that's the time zone of India, where the time is 9 a.m. So if it is 9 a.m. here, in the next time zone there will be 10 a.m. This place is in the east of our location. We are here, so this is in our east side. That means they have already experienced 9 a.m. and they are in the next hour now. So they are there, the time is 10 a.m. So if we go one more time zone towards the east, there it will be 11 a.m. now. If we go one more now, there will be 12, that means noon time. If you go to the next time zone, that will be 1 o'clock, that is 1 o'clock in the noon, 1 p.m. next time zone it will be 2 p.m. now we have to go to the next time zone, that is here, that will be 3 p.m. and at 180 degree meridian it will be 4 p.m. so here in India we have the time as 9 a.m. Saturday 9 a.m. now. So this Saturday 10 a.m. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, that is 4 p.m. So at 180 degree meridian, or the time zone here in the international dateline, the time now is Saturday 4 p.m. That is what I shown here. Now on the other hand, here in the western hemisphere, at this place the time is same 4 p.m. but it is Friday 4 p.m. right, previous day. They are still in Friday. Now it will be clear if I tell you the next one thing. So imagine here it is Friday 4 p.m. so time comes from the eastern side, because earth is rotating from west to east, so east experience the time first. So here now it is Friday 4 p.m. and here this is the midnight between Friday and Saturday. So these places are still in Friday, they have not yet experienced Saturday. So if here it is 4 p.m. Friday, this will be 5 p.m. Friday. This will be 6 p.m. Friday. This is 7 p.m. Friday. 8, 9, 10, 11 p.m. Friday. And here it is 12 p.m. Friday. Correct. So now at this moment of time, if it is 9 a.m., if you are watching this video at 9 a.m., this is the time across the world. Somewhere here in this longitude, there will be midnight. There is places in Brazil and all, they will be having midnight now. You are here in India and you have time as 9 a.m. and at 180 degree meridian, it is 4 p.m. Saturday. But on the other side of the 180 degree meridian, that is international dateline, it is Friday 4 p.m. Now, what will happen after 1 hour? Right, everything will change. 1 hour change will happen. Now, in India, the time will become 10 a.m. Next time zone, it will be 11 a.m. This will be 12. It will be 1 p.m., 2 p.m., 3 p.m., 4 p.m., 5 p.m. Here, it will become 5 p.m. So, here also same thing. Friday, 5 p.m. That 1 hour of the Friday is already gone. Now, time zone, this midnight is also shifted towards the west side. Right? After 1 hour, this will all shift towards eastern side one more time. That means India will have 11 a.m. Right? Then again, next hour it will be 12 a.m. So if it go this in this way, after 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 hours, this area will have the midnight time. Right? And in India, time will become 16, that is 4 o'clock. Now see the scenario. After another 6 hours, the scenario will be like this. So earlier we had 9 a.m. as the time. Then hours passed. Now our time is 4 p.m. in the evening. So here, when it is 4 p.m. here in the evening, here only this much area is now having Friday. So here we have midnight time, right? So Saturday has started on this particular longitude. This place is now having the time 12 o'clock Saturday. On the other hand, this small area, they have come to the end of Friday, 11:30 p.m. Friday, only this much area. But here, which is on the other side of the international dateline, they have came to the end of Saturday, right? Here in the western hemisphere, this much area have came to the end of Friday, but here they have already reached the end of Saturday. So there is again a difference of 24 hours timing. Every time there is a difference of 24 hours between this side of the international dateline, that is the eastern side of the international dateline and the western side of the international dateline. Now what will happen in the next half an hour? In the next half an hour, the midnight will reach here. That means Friday is completely over. Now this place also started experiencing Saturday. So here it is Saturday 12 a.m. And at the same time, in the eastern hemisphere, the next day has started. Now there the time is again midnight, but it's the next day, Sunday. And this continues. So this is the interesting fact. There is a time difference of 12 hours on either side of international dateline. Now moving on to the next one thing, you look at the shape of international dateline. You must have seen this in your textbook as well as in the previous slides which are shown. So it's not a straight line, right? It has got a zigzag shape. Now why is it in this shape? It's very simple. We'll take again with an example. So here this is the international dateline. You can see two places. I used two red dots. Sorry, two dots. One is a red dot and one is a blue dot. So if this one particular part of the this is actually part of Russia. If they follow the exact time according to longitudes, red dot and this blue dot, I mean the place on this red dot and blue dot will actually have a difference of 24 hours time. But both these places are part of one single country, maybe part of one single province. So just imagine that two places of one same province is having a 24 hours time difference. How difficult it will be for them to manage each and everything. So in order to avoid this kind of problem, some manual adjustment is made in the international dateline so that this entire area which belongs to one particular state or a country will have same time. Now, if you take another example, we have this group of islands here. These are part of Alaska. We call it as Aleutian Islands. So these islands actually are located on two sides of interstate line. So if they were to follow the exact timing, so then this island group will have two different timing. Not only two different timings, there will be a difference of 24 hours. When these islands experience Saturday, or when the time in these islands are Saturday, here it will be Friday. One day difference within same group of islands. That will make a lot of confusions and problems. So to avoid this, some slight changes are made in the international line. You can see this in many places. If you go down south here, again this is international date line. So all these islands, in order to have one single timing, here also some deviations are made in the international date line. Here also same thing. It's not only in the international date line, this kind of adjustment is made in almost all the standard meridians, only for the purpose of maintaining one single time within one province. If you see this one particular longitude, you can see, right, it has again deviated. So the reason is that you look at this island, this is called as Iceland, one country. So here actually the original longitude is passing through the land area. If they were to follow the exact timing, this part of the country will have 1 hour difference from the other part of the country. So again, that will make lot of confusion. So in order to avoid this kind of confusions, countries according to their convenience made some adjustments in the longitudes, right? So that is the reason why the international date line is not a straight line, it has a zigzag shape. Now there is another one interesting thing, that is this one. If we go eastwards and cross the international date line, you will gain a day, right? I mean it. So if you go eastwards, right, imagine you are going towards east, right, from the eastern hemisphere you are going further east. That is, imagine you are in Japan and you are going eastwards and you are crossing international date line. So as soon as you cross the international date line, you will gain one whole day, or that means you will get 24 hours extra in your life, right? That's possible because we have seen just now that the time difference between both places on either side of the international date line is 24 hours. Imagine you are going from here and here, it is Saturday. Take the same time, 4 p.m. As soon as you jump to the other side, you will reach Friday 4 p.m. which you have already experienced when you were in the eastern hemisphere, right? So imagine if you are going from here to this side, already you have experienced Friday 4 p.m. 24 hours ago. And once you cross this, you will again reach the same Friday 4 p.m. Then you will now get Friday 5 p.m., 6 p.m., midnight, then Saturday morning, Saturday evening, up to Saturday 4 p.m. That means you are getting exactly one day extra in your life. Right. So that means if you go eastwards and cross the international date line, you will gain a day. Right. On the other hand, if you go westwards and cross the international date line, you will lose one day. Same thing, you take the same example, time is Friday 4 p.m. here. Imagine you are going westward, you are coming from America and you are crossing international date line. Immediately after crossing the international date line, you will reach Saturday 4 p.m. and you will miss all the time from Friday 4 p.m. to Saturday 4 p.m. You will not see Friday 10 o'clock at night, you will not see Friday Saturday midnight, you will not see Saturday morning, because you are directly reaching Saturday 4 p.m. After 1 hour here, the time will become Saturday 5 p.m. That means you missed out the entire Friday. So if you go westwards and cross the international date line, you will lose a day. If you go eastwards and cross the international date line, you will gain a day. Now the last topic is time zones. We have already discussed this, may not be under the heading, but we have seen this many times. Let's see the definition. A range of longitudes where a common standard time is used, or an area between a given longitude, a selected longitude where one single time is practiced, is called as time zone. This time zone is defined by dividing the 360 degrees of the earth by the rate of the rotation. The rate of the rotation is 15 degree, and when we divide this 360 degree with 15 degree, we will get 24. So that means we have 24 time zones, right? We know that after every 15 degree there is a difference of 1 hour time. So we have 24 hours in a day, 24 time zones. Now here you can see the time zones. We start the calculation from prime meridian. So this particular time zone, that is this is 0 degree meridian, so this is actually 15 degrees in difference. So 7.5 degree west to 7.5 degree east. So this much area is following one single time, that is the time on the median meridian, I mean the central meridian. So the central meridian in this time zone is prime meridian. So whatever be the time on prime meridian, that time is followed in all these regions, including this Iceland, then this part of Africa. Some adjustments are made so that this entire area can follow one single time. And if you take this example here, all these areas are following another time. That means time of this zone is 1 hour ahead of Greenwich Mean Time, because this is in the eastern side of Greenwich Mean Time. Here it will be plus 2 hours, right? Whatever be the time is in Greenwich, from there this zone will have this zone will be 2 hours ahead. This will be 3 hours ahead. This will be 4 hours ahead. This will be 5 hours ahead. And we in India, we follow the time on this one particular longitude. We know that it is the standard meridian of India, 82 degree 30 minutes east, or we can call as 82.5 degree east. So whatever be the time on this particular longitude, we follow that for the entire country. And this time is actually 5 hours 30 minutes ahead of the time of the prime meridian. So when it is 12 noon here, right, 12 o'clock, our time will be 12 o'clock plus 5 hours 30 minutes. That means 17.5, which is equal to 5:30 p.m. right? So that is the time we follow, right? If you see all the entire map, you can see certain countries are having multiple time zones. Take the case of Russia. Russia's eastern end is here, this one, this color, orangish color, and the not the eastern end, western end, and the eastern end is not here, here this blue, right? So this much area comes under one single country. So they cannot follow a single time zone. Imagine if they are following time of this particular longitude. When it is 12 o'clock here, actually here it will be, I mean 12 noon, here it will be very dark. So it will be very weird if we call this time also as 12 noon. Or if they follow any other longitude, again same problem will be there. So since these countries have very vast longitudinal extension, for the convenience, they divided into multiple time zones. Or you take the case of Australia. Again, Australia is a vast country. There also they have 3 time zones. Otherwise, again, it will make a lot of issues. We also have the same problem in India. When it is 4 a.m. when it is 4 a.m. in Arunachal Pradesh, sun rises there actually. But since we follow the time of this particular meridian, time is only 4 a.m. Actually, there's a difference of 2 hours between eastern and western side of India. Since it is only 2 hours, we don't have much issues. But countries like Australia or Russia or Canada or USA, they will have more issues. So they follow multiple time zones. Right? That's about our lesson. Now you have to go through the textbook, refer the textbook, and we'll meet in the WhatsApp group. Thank you.